Hi, I'm Max Kaiser. This is the Kaiser Report. You, like me, are probably sick of all those loveys in the UK. Well, that's about to change. Stacey, tell me.
Max is more than that. Here is Ken Livingstone running for mayor of London, and this is his message. Ken Livingstone, hang a banker a week. Mayor of London candidate Ken Livingstone has sparked a new outrage after telling an audience, hang a banker a week until the others improve. Your message is getting through. We've talked here on a range of items relating to that if you don't bring justice to the banking system, you're going to see city crime after city crime after banking crime. Why did the whole city of London not stop with their crime wave after Lehman Brothers? Why did they not stop after the Bernie Madoff fraud? Why did they not stop after the AIG fraud? Why did they just commit the MF Global fraud and facilitate that? Why? Because there was no justice. There were not even little tiny slaps on the wrist, let alone hang a banker. And the hang a banker option is the revolutionary option. This is what happens when there is no justice.
Yeah, the noose is nature's way of taking care of the banker overpopulation. They're a cancer, they're a parasite. Ken Livingstone is correct. Hang a banker a week until they get the frickin' message.
Well, of course, we also spoke to William K. Black, who is a former prosecutor of white collar crimes, of banking fraud. And he said that if you look back at the French philosopher Bastiat, who said that this sort of fraud trickles down. And here's a tweet I read, Max. Greek authorities say major armed robbery carried out at ancient Olympia Museum. Now, my first instinct was, wow, this is a headline from AP that their mainstream media is actually starting to report what is happening to Greece in the real terms of what has happened.
Yeah, right. Well, my immediate thought was, my God, did Britain steal the Elgin marbles again? No, apparently it's a new band of thieves, and they're taking everything but the Elgin marbles. And of course, you find this at the nexus of any wholesale devastation that's occurred in an economy that's been gutted by thieves and bankers in the city of London or on Wall Street.
It is a financial war and it is a financial attack on Greece happening, as we've pointed out here many times. So I went to the expert on war. I went to Donald Rumsfeld and I asked him what he thought of this looting of the museum in Greece.
Stuff happens and it's untidy, and freedom's untidy, and free people are free to make mistakes and commit crimes and do bad things.
Yes, the ever-sensitive Donald Rumsfeld.
And of course, this is a continuation on the theme of banking fraud. So, what did Alan Greenspan actually intentionally allowed wanted fraud to flourish, bank robbery to flourish, because he said it would help the banking system. So perhaps these robbers are just trying to unfreeze the liquidity that is happening in Greece. So perhaps this is what they were just listening to, Sir Alan Greenspan.
That's right. Greenspan said that the inherent conflict of interest between the broker-dealer specialist system on the floor of the exchange, which encouraged insider trading, was needed to facilitate liquidity or market making. And so he turned an eye away from obvious front-running and stealing on the exchange. But now that little piece wiggle worm of fraud has become the de facto operating system of the entire US and UK economy. It's all run on front running and fraud, and the defense is always we're market making, which Lloyd Blankfein famously has claimed many times over again. And what all the bankers claim is that we're not stealing, we're making a market. It's not fraud, it's FRUD. It's trading on the NASDAQ, and we're making a market in it. And you can buy into it as well. Why are you looking at us as if we're committing some kind of sin? Don't you get it? You can become a fraudster as well.